Hey guys, FrigoDX here. So yeah, I have my Alfred build now. Technically it's not mine, it's my friend's, but I haven't formed it. So this is my preferred build, I guess. So yeah, starter would be Wingard Brave Liberator. His skill is pretty weird, I would say, but yeah, it does help to force your opponent to guard. So usually when people find out that you have a Blaster Blade Liberator in your soul, they would tend to guard the attack that is boosted by this unit so that it won't superior call Blaster Blade Liberator. So yeah, I find the aspect of this card pretty cool, so yeah, I run him as the starter. And yeah, so moving on, starting from the great trees, I mean. For my great trees, I run 3 Alfreds. I don't run 4 because Alfred doesn't have a rear guard ability. Nor does it actually benefit me to play more. Unlike Gancelot. Yeah, it doesn't actually have any benefits if I actually play more. The only reason why I play 3 is so that it comes out and I don't have to suffer without using him throughout the whole game, so yeah, that's why I play 3. Oh yeah, also it's actually quite good as a rear guard, I would say. Because it can also be boosted by Lion Mane Stallion in the rear guard column. Yeah, the only worry is that there's not enough soul for him to Lion Mane Stallion to Soul Blast, so yeah. And yeah, the finishing up the rest of the great trees would be 4 Gancelots. Yeah, Gancelots are good cards. Yeah, I explained them in my previous video, the one about the trial deck, so yeah, I won't spend too much time on them now. Yeah, so great trees, I run 7 great trees. Okay, moving on to the great twos, I run 11. Yeah, so starting off, I play 4 Blaster Blade Liberator. I didn't want to do this initially, and I wanted to play like 2 Blaster Blade Liberators and like a few Gadgetins, another 2 Gadgetins, so that I can use it as my Vanguard. But then I realized that due to Wingard Brave Liberator skill, actually having Blaster Blade Liberator in your soul which would require you to actually ride it as your Vanguard. So I decided to play 4 so that it does come out and I'd be able to ride it as my Vanguard. And yeah, it does help quite a lot having it as a decoy. Even though the attack might hit, I might not even get it out, or I might get it out and not even use the skill. So I can use it as a 9k rearguard and attack other rearguards except for 10k's, but yeah, it's pretty good, I guess. Its skill is not bad also. So yeah, play 4 of them because it's my ideal Vanguard. Next, I play 3 Escarat, which is the Vivian clone, if I'm not wrong. I never played Gold Paladin before, but people tell me that it's the Vivian clone, so you know. Yeah. Its skill is that when the attack hits, Counterblast 1, look at the top card of your deck and superior call it to an open rear guard space. Yeah, this card's not bad. It helps your opponent to specially guard this unit, so that you won't have an additional rear guard. So yeah, people tend to start panicking when they see this card and target it, hence wasting one attack of theirs, or guard whenever I attack with it. So they also, you know, have to guard it. If not, I can superior call one. But I guess one of the weaknesses of this deck is that when you only can counterblast liberators. So yeah, that's a extremely bad weakness to me. Yeah, so I only play 3. And lastly, to finish up my great force, I play the 12k for Ferens. Yeah, it's a 12k, it's good. Yeah, no, nothing more to say about this. And to the great ones, I play 15. So, this would be the worst card in this deck, for the only reason that it is not a liberator. I played the game before where my damage zone had 2 Gareths and I was like suffering throughout the whole game because that's like 2 counter blasts that I cannot use at all. So yeah, this card would be best if you do ride it as your Vanguard and, you know, try not to get into the damage zone. I mean, that is like extremely hard to say, but yeah, I play him because 8Ks are good, but yeah, if they do create an 8K Liberator, that would be the best. But still, I play 4. Yeah, so there's a higher chance for him to become my Vanguard. And yeah, if your opponent doesn't get their 8K, they might not even be able to attack you. But of course, your rear guards can be pushed back, I guess. Okay, moving on, I play 4 Halo Shield. 4 Negates, you know, enough said. And for Yusuf, this card is extremely good, like, to me. Firstly, it's a 7k booster, and plus its skill is that when you superior call this, you get to soul blast 1 and draw a card. So this card, every time I like use Escarats, whenever I use Escarats, counter blast or the Alfred's as special counterblast, I always, and every time that this card appears, I would instantly become happy because this card is like 4 out of 50 of a deck, and yet if it does appear during a special counterblast, it really does help. So yeah, I would, yeah, this card is really good. I like this card. It does help you to get extra card and also get a 7k booster, so you know, this card's not bad. And lastly, 3 Lion Mane Stallion. I play 3 because it's an Alfred booster, and since I only play 3 Alfreds, I decided to play 3 of these. So yeah, its skill is Soul Blast 1, and Alfred gets plus 5k when this unit is boosting it. So it doesn't matter if it's Rearguard or Vanguard, it can still boost. So yeah, I play this instead of Liu, because Liu can only boost the Vanguard, and yeah, it's only a 10k boost. Yeah, I think I might have forgot to mention Alfred's skill. Yeah, Alfred's skill is Limit Break 4. For every Liberator on your field, it gets plus 2k. That's where Gareth's weakness comes in once again. Because Gareth isn't a Liberator, so it cannot be part of the 2k. Yeah, its second skill is Counterblast 2 Liberators and check the top card of the deck and Superior Call it. Superior Call it. So yeah, it's the special counterblast, and yeah, it chains really well with high attacking, high offensive units, as well as units like Lion Mane to boost himself, and yeah, Yusuf. And yeah, lastly the triggers, I play 8 crits. The new Eponas look really nice, so 4 new Eponas, 4 of the trial deck Strike Liberators, 4 draw triggers, and 4 heal. So yeah, this trigger lineup is basically my favorite trigger lineup. Most of my decks, I think I play 8 crit and 4 draws. But except for my Tachikaze, and yeah, my Tachikaze, which I play 6 draw and 6 crit, cause I need the draws. Other than that, yeah, I think that 8 crits and 4 draws are a good combination. Yeah, so that's it for my Liberator deck profile. Yeah, if you have any questions or anything, yeah, just, you know, comment in the comment section below. And yeah, so thanks for watching this video, guys. I hope it helped you. And yeah, this might not be the best deck build, but yeah, to me it's good. To me, I like playing it this way, so it's my personal opinion. And I use Vanguard Brave Liberator, so yeah, thanks for watching. Comment, subscribe, like this video, and yeah, so Frigo DX here, bye.